So Earl took two of the very early Johnson & Johnson products. He took surgical adhesive tape. He took a piece of surgical adhesive tape, 18 inches long, 3 inches wide, laid a strip of gauze right down the middle. He covered it with fabric, and he rolled it up.
I think it was. All right.
So when his wife cut herself, she could just unroll whatever width she needed, cut it across so that it was sticky on either side, pat in the middle, and put it on. It worked really well. It protected the cut while it healed. It was very easy to put on one-handed. And she really liked it. Thought it was a great idea, who told by then company president James Wood Johnson. James was an engineer, so of course he really loved the idea, and in 1921, Johnson & Johnson put it on the market as Band-Aid brand adhesive bandages. The name Band-Aid just comes from aiding bandages.
Well, duct tape.
Yeah.
It was the first pre-prepared dressing for small wounds for consumers, and it was such a new concept that nobody knew how to use it. So Johnson & Johnson had to send its salesman out with scissors to demonstrate how to use it to the retail pharmacists who sold their products at the time, so that then they could take the product and demonstrate it to the consumers.
Narrowly down.
It's like asking you to pick a favorite candy.
Besides baby powder, Band-Aids,
first aid kit.
We also did a lot of advertising, and we gave free samples out to Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, butchers, carpenters, anyone who might need Band-Aid brand adhesive bandage, and sales took off, and it became one of the iconic consumer products.